the long-lived Zora, who could traverse rivers and lakes with ease, lived in Laneru at a resplendent place dubbed Zora's Domain. Mipha, a Zora princess with the power to heal others' wounds, was selected to pilot divine beast Varuta. Accompanied by Link and the rest of her party, Zelda headed to Zora's domain, where she was granted an audience with King Dorophan.
Mipha, pilot the divine beast.
Yes. My father, King Rome, has faith she will do her utmost. With your permission, of course.
This will be a dangerous mission. Piloting the divine beast against the darkness. And I understand that the knight who will seal that darkness has not yet appeared.
That is true.
I must refuse. I cannot send my daughter into such peril.
But I...
Your Majesty! I bring news!
Well, Link, you've grown since I last saw you. And yet, you have not changed. This creature is a guardian? How cute!
Princess Mipha! Monsters on Ploymus Mountain, marching this way.
What of my father?
His Majesty is leading the army to intercept. He thought the prince was here with you.
Sidon is missing. We will find Sidon. You must watch over the domain.
Highness!
Huh!
Huh?
I won't give up.
I will try.
Lady Leaf.
Hands
Thank you. All right.
Robin?
Nice one!
Ah!
Mipha?
What is that?
Thank you.
This attack proves your point. We are woefully unprepared to defend against the Calamity. The Zora will face this peril head-on. We must consider the future. We all share this land of Hyrule. So all of us must do our part. Mipha, attend.
Yes, Father.
You will become the pilot of the divine beast, Varuta. On one condition. You must promise to come back safely.
This looks quite
what
satisfying.
A treat. Mm-hmm.
The rugged Gorons lived in Goron City, a town carved into Death Mountain. They were forged in volcanic heat, their bodies as hard as stone. Daruk, a brave Goron whose power of protection could repel the mightiest of blows, was deemed the best candidate to pilot divine beast Varudanya. The princess and her entourage ventured to Goron City in hopes of securing Daruk's cooperation.
What you'll learn about me is that I never refuse a sincere request. So of course I'm on board with your plan. Except there is one problem. It's just Varudanya is in a difficult spot right now. The Divine Beast was found pretty high up on Death Mountain. A lot of monsters have been crawling around lately, so even getting close to Varudanya is a big pain. Only the bravest go up there now. So that's why it's a good thing it's gonna be us!
Of course.
Come on! Death Mountain won't climb itself. Okay.
Hey!
nothing to it!
Yeah, nothing to it!
Let's get right to it then! Ooh, I can't wait!
Thank you.
That was unexpected, but we pulled through in the end. You really proved yourself, hey, little guy? Now, about me piloting Rutania. Well, go ahead and count the mighty Daruk in.
Oh, thank you, Daruk.
Of course! We'll smash that Calamity Cannon jerk to smithereens! Oh, wait a minute. You must be starving after all that fighting. I know just the cure for that. My favorite, prime rock roast. Doesn't it look delicious? Why don't you dig in, little guy? Sorry, how thoughtless of me. I should have brought some for you, tiny princess. Next time, I promise to bring enough for everyone.
Thank you very much.
You did well.
Good work! Next battle's on me!
I can feel the power!
beautiful work.
This looks quite satisfying.
The Rito resided in a settlement on the Tabantha frontier. These feathery folk were blessed with the ability to glide along the wind, and they were adept with bow and arrow. Counted among them was Revale, the most capable warrior of all the Rito. The natural choice to pilot divine beast Var Meadow. Zelda and her companions set out for Rito Village in hopes of securing his help. To evade foes, the party tried crossing through the snowfield, but a fierce blizzard befell them, halting their progress. Link asked Zelda to wait in safety while he and the little guardian scouted the area.
This nonsense again? Rito Village is my home. While I'm here, you won't be getting any closer.
Red.
bad result.
Really now?
Link!
Ha!
I see.
I understand the situation now. I'm thankful no harm befell you. Either of you.
Pardon me.
Huh?
But we must address the gravity of there being another guardian resembling the little one, Your Highness.
Yes. If it is in some way connected to the calamity, we must swiftly come up with a strategy.
Out with it. We both know you'll be needing my unique skills to pilot that divine beast. However, about this pathetic knight in your service, are you sure he's got what it takes? What the?
Oh, I see. Our friend believes itself to be a knight as well, in service of the princess.
It... what? Ridiculous. Every last one of you. I've outdone myself.
Good work!
I refuse to be anything less than capable.
This looks quite treat. Satisfying.
The Gerudo lived in a settlement in the Gerudo Desert. Comprised entirely of women, They were a tribe of great might and nobility. For her exceptional strength and her ability to harness lightning, Urbosa, chief of the Gerudo, was the clear choice to pilot divine beast Var Naboris. Zelda knew Urbosa thanks to her close relationship with the late Queen of Hyrule. With her party in tow, Zelda traveled to Gerudo Town to speak with her old friend. However, their journey took an unexpected turn.
But why? Why are the Gerudo attacking us?
Urbosa will surely be able to explain everything if we can reach her.
Huh!
you doing?
Thwarting your destiny, of course. Princess Zelda. I came back as quickly as I could. Not exactly what I expected to find.
Abosa?
I hope you're not hurt, little bird.
I'm not.
Oh, esse quadro se morda caliente! You've got some nerve, thinking you can go toe-to-toe with Master Koga! I'll show you! Yiga, assemble! Me excluded, of course.
What?
Over! Over for you!
Of course.
Over here!
How could these losers defeat me?
Master Koga.
Suga, you're late! I nearly got peeled like a banana! Oh.
Forget these cowards. It's time to retreat.
I think not!
Thank you for meeting me here. The town is a bit, chaotic, shall we say.
Of course, Abosa. We'd meet you anywhere.
You know about the Yiga clan, I trust. Sheikah traitors working in the shadows to revive Calamity Ganon. Those lowlifes have been wreaking havoc here in Gerudo Canyon. How long can we stand by and watch them get away with it? No longer, I say. I will pilot this divine beast. You are precious to me, and you need my help. I cannot refuse.
Thank you, Urbosa. As Princess of Hyrule, I too will carry out my sworn duty.
Little bird. However I am able to support you, I will. Just say the word.
So, you turned and fled. Is that it?
Well, if they hadn't interrupted me...
It seems that, as low as my expectations of you were, I was overly optimistic.
What?
Well, no matter. My harbinger. Show me the future.
Oh!
Yes. The future, as it will and must be, I will not allow anyone to alter its course.
Yeah.